Yo, what's good with y'all? It's koreaxo. And today, I'm going to be showing y'all niggas how to make glorytee SLUMP6 Phoenix. my fault. Yo, what's good with y'all? It's koreaxo. And I'm finna show y'all how to make SLUMP6 glorytee Phoenix type beats. Basically, like a war Call of Duty type shit. So basically, I'm finna play y'all this little beat I made from start to finish. I'm gonna break down the melody, I'm gonna break down the drums, and I'm gonna break down structure and probably.
Dumb that ass. Yes, sir.
What STREO did on to make this melody. Basically, I'm gonna try to break it down as best as I can. I don't really know exactly what sounds he used, but I'll have a pretty good idea of what he did on this. So for this first song right here, this is gonna be a full orchestra brass from X-Band. And the next sound, I'm pretty sure you use a SR deep brass. It's pretty similar to the Venexi 3K drum kit, the brass that's in there. Basically, any deep low brass that you can find will be good for these type of beats. Alright, and the next sound, this is a violin. So I'm not really sure what VST he used or what effects he put on it, but this is definitely a violin. All right, and this next song will be a piano. Piano, I'm pretty sure you just added a little bit of delay. You can hear it kind of. And right here, I just layered the same full orchestra brass right here so that it hits harder. And I did the same thing with this deep brass. And now it's all like it comes together a little bit better for me, so that's why I did that. These are strings right here. I don't know what VST again he used, but these are strings. My fault if my recording's lagging. It's cause like I got a lot of shit running in the background, and my PC is ass. And this is a choir. This is a choir right here. Pretty sure it's from Arcade. I'm not really sure. But this is just a lead. I don't know what lead this is, but I know it's a lead. Might be a polytune. Come on, shoot. But now, moving on to the drums. So basically, to start the drums off, I added this transition from typical 1K's kit. And it basically, it's like a cool transition that like hits. I don't know like how to explain it, but just listen. That shit is so hard. And, this right here, this is just a war drum type loop from typical Phoenix. Shout out to Phoenix for like pretty sure he's the one that started this Glory T shit. I mean, Call of Duty shit. And that's pretty much it for the, like, the beginning. Oh, yeah, I also added this transition. Just for when I'm adding more sound to the melody, it can transition better. And this right here, this is just, like, a snare rolls that I added to kick off the drums. All sounds that I use in this beat, like, all drum sounds are all found in my kit. So if y'all want any of these sounds, just hit me up on IG. I'll send them to you. And that's basically just a simple clap pattern here. And it's right here. This is a hi-hat. The hi-hats on like these type of beats, they don't need to be too complicated. They just need to flow well with your other drums and your perks that you got. So with this hi-hat, I feel like it matches pretty well with the clap right here. Again, this hi-hat is found in my kit. I like this hi-hat because it's like, it gives it like a little, it has a sharp noise to it. And this is a snare I added. It's just little snare rolls. Nothing too crazy. This is a bell I made. Usually on these beats, they have bells, so I added it. Alright, and this is like, I don't know how I made this, but it's very hard in my opinion. I forgot what I did. That basically, like I was talking about earlier, it leads up with the clap right here. See? And yeah, I added that. This is an open hat. Pretty sure that just sits on the 808. And for this, I didn't do too much on the second part of the beat. I just added this chant. Chants for my kit too. The snare. And this snare pretty matches up pretty well with the hi-hat. Type shit. And for the part, y'all always be asking me about 808s and how do I make my 808s, how do I tune it. Bro, it's really not that hard. Usually for my 808s, I usually make, like, I would say on 75% of my beats, I use my own, like, 808s that I either put together using different sounds or I use other people's. It's one between, it's like between both of those. And for this one, I made this 808. I just put two sounds together on this, and it's going to sound like this.
And right here.
Yeah. Why can I hear myself? What's funny?
Hold on, you can hear yourself?
I'm muting you.
You hear yourself now?
No. Alright, anyways, back to the tutorial. Basically, what I was trying to tell y'all is... right here, I added a special mystery preset that I made. So that's why it sounds like it, like, in between the 808, it, like, switches up. Yeah, so that's basically what I did on that. If you want that mixer preset and if you want that 808, just hit me up on IG. I got you. I also made this 808. No, I didn't make it. I didn't make this 808, but it's in my kit. Somebody sent me that 808 a while ago, and I thought it was very hard, so, you know. try to put on this beat. And that's pretty much it. Oh, yeah, right here. The CTM. This is just a normal CTM. I just put a mixer preset that I made on it to make it sound harder. Tip for y'all that I be seeing making glory TV. So y'all be doing too much with y'all 808s, and like half of the tone, it only needs like a few notes on your 808 as long as it's hitting and as long as there's enough like breathing room for your other perks and everything else that you're gonna add. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the beat. Shout out STREO, shout out glory T, and shout out Phoenix who made this genre and shit.
Shout out 2D Fame Glory. That nigga's the GOAT.
Anyways, bro, I got some other shit to do right now. I gotta go.
Did I get you?
Alright, bro, I'm gonna see y'all in the next tutorial. Put down in the comments what y'all want me to do next.
Losers.